there be life somewhere in the solar system outside Earth? Since the mid-20th century, active ongoing research has taken place to look for signs of extraterrestrial life. It is a fascinating concept that has captured the imagination of many people for decades. Scientists are now becoming increasingly convinced that the planet Earth is not the only place on the universe capable of hosting life. Water covers approximately 70% of our beloved planet today. That wasn't always the case. New research suggests that the ancient Earth was once covered in water, a true ocean world some 3 billion years ago. Much of it is now thought to have evaporated or frozen into our planet's polar ice. An early Earth without emergent continents may provide an important environmental constraint on the origin and evolution of life on Earth, as well as its possible existence elsewhere.
So every cell in your body now, if you look at your finger, or you look at your arm, or you look at your friend sitting next to you, the cells in their bodies are doing some of the chemistry that we think occurred on the Earth 3.8 billion years ago. It's not the chemistry of the Earth today. The Earth was a very strange place 3.8 billion years ago. The oceans were very acidic. There was no oxygen in the atmosphere because there were no plants to put the oxygen into the atmosphere. And yet, in a way, our cells in our bodies are recreating those conditions.
The elements associated with life, available sources of energy, appear to be almost everywhere we've looked. The Milky Way could harbour billion Earth-like planets, and we are only just beginning to scratch the surface of the universe. While no clear signs of life have ever been detected, many astrobiologists think that life in space is likely, but millions of light years away from Earth. Yet there are few possible places to look for right here in our solar system.
The idea now is that everywhere, well, it's a theory, everywhere you find conditions like that, you find life. Life is inevitable. If you get water, you get volcanic activity, you get the right mixture of things and the right lengths of time. Is that right? Or is it that life is unique or very rare in the universe and Earth is a unique place? Well, there are other places in the solar system we've already found where conditions may exist that are similar to those events. This is one of the moons of Saturn called Titan. Fascinating place. This is an atmosphere. It's like Earth's atmosphere. It's blue sky. It's what you see there, the gases in the atmosphere. Much thicker than the Earth's atmosphere. Now, Titan's a very cold place, but it's interesting because we've landed on Titan. We landed, the European space probe Huygens parachuted through this atmosphere a few years ago now, and it landed on mushy, wet ground. Now, it wasn't water because it's very cold on Titan. It was actually methane. So if you have a barbecue in the summer, you might use one of those gas canisters with methane in. At these temperatures, methane can be a liquid. So Titan is a place where there are rivers of methane. There is methane snow falling on the surface. There are oceans of methane. And people are already speculating that possibly there might be some kind of very strange forms of life on Titan. Could it be? There's lots of liquid. There are rivers and there are oceans. And it's a very strange place, but a place that's not covered in water. It's covered in methane, although there may be some evidence that there may be remains of water perhaps below the surface. A very interesting place.
Titan is the largest moon of Saturn and the second largest natural satellite in the solar system. It is the only moon known to have a dense atmosphere and the only moon or planet other than Earth on which clear evidence of stable bodies of surface liquid water has been found. Titan seems to contain a global ocean beneath its ice shell, and within this ocean, conditions are potentially suitable for microbial life. Laboratory simulations have led to the suggestion that enough organic material exists on Titan to start a chemical evolution analogous to what is thought to have started life on Earth. The analogy assumes the presence of liquid water for longer periods than is currently observable. Several hypotheses postulate that liquid water from an impact could be preserved under a frozen isolation layer. It has been speculated that life could exist in the lakes of liquid methane on Titan, just as organisms on Earth live in water. However, methane-based life forms are only hypothetical. Scientists have not yet detected this form of life anywhere.
Enceladus, which is quite a small moon. But Cassini swept over the surface of Enceladus and took pictures. Look at these plumes rising up from the surface. Those are water. Those are jets of water spraying up from the surface of Enceladus, which tells us that there must be at least frozen water and perhaps pockets of liquid below the surface of Enceladus. Could this be a place where we find simple microbes? It might be too small, but it's interesting because there's water there.
For decades, scientists didn't know why Enceladus was the brightest world in our solar system, or how it's related to Saturn's E-ring. Cassini found that both the fresh coating on the surface and icy material in the E-ring originate from vents connected to a global subsurface subwater ocean that might host hydrothermal vents. Planetary scientists now have Enceladus to consider as a possible habitat for life. Enceladus is also known for having geysers that shoot out on its surface and into space. These geysers are constantly bringing nutrients from the ocean to the surface where they can be studied. Could these be signs of life?
This is a place where we are very certain there's a lot of water. This is a place that we're going to explore with a space mission again in the next 10, 15 or 20 years. There are plans to send a very dedicated mission to go and look at this moon. This is the moon of Jupiter called Europa. This moon has got an icy crust. The ice is probably around 100 kilometres thick, but we know that below that ice there's an ocean of liquid water, and there's more water in the oceans of Europa than there is in all of the oceans of the Earth combined. And we think there may be hydrothermal vents below that ocean on Europa. So one of the great challenges, and this is perhaps for 30, 40 years in the future, how would you burrow through 100 kilometres of ice to get a submarine into the oceans of Europa to see what's down there? There may be living things in that ocean, we don't know. It's a challenge to you. No one's thought of a way of doing it, but everybody wants to go there because there's an ocean waiting to be explored.
Jupiter's large icy moon Europa has the smoothest surface of any known solid object in the solar system. This led to the hypothesis that the water ocean exists beneath the surface, which could conceivably harbour extraterrestrial life. The energy provided by tidal heating from Jupiter's gravity gives rise to most of the geologic activity on Europa. Europa is far away out of the Goldilocks zone, but is kept warm by the gravitational stress that Jupiter brings. Could this deep ocean be a home to life?
Nearer to home and nearer in time is the exploration of Mars. This is one of Mars's polar caps. They're ice caps. There's carbon dioxide ice in those caps. There's also water in those ice caps. So we know there's water ice on Mars. What I find fascinating about this is that we know there was water on Mars. We know there were oceans and rivers on Mars billions of years ago. Mars has lost its water because it was smaller than the Earth, but we don't know where the water went. It could be that there is liquid water below the surface of Mars. How did it vanish? Is it still there in some sense? There's a European mission called ExoMars, which is going to go to Mars. Its job is to look for life. Perhaps there was life there that's now died out. Perhaps there are still microbes beneath the surface of Mars.
Mars, too, used to be more watery than it is today, and there might be enough frozen water at the Martian poles today to support life. More recently, European Space Agency has uncovered significant amounts of water in Mars' Grand Canyon, the largest canyon in the solar system. Compared to Earth's Grand Canyon, it is 10 times longer and 5 times deeper. Scientists have made many claims that alien life could exist in our solar system, but so far none have been proven. So there you have it. The future holds promise for discovering extraterrestrial life, be it present or past. If we eventually find some form of life at Europa, or Mars or Enceladus for that matter, even life that looks like microbes, it can be demonstrated that life formed independently in two places around the same star. Then it would be reasonable to suspect that life might be found throughout the universe once the necessary ingredients are present. What do you think? Tell us in the comments below. Thanks for watching. Did you like this video? then show your support by subscribing and ringing the bell to never miss videos like this.